Hello friends, welcome back to Civil3D Pro Trips and Tricks YouTube channel. Thanks for liking our videos, subscribing our channels, and please turn on the notification for the latest video update. And today the topic of the video is the breaklines. Well, you heard a lot about the breaklines. We'll see how we can use them and how we can create them. So the breaklines generally will be a feature line or your 3D polyline, and they are used to create any surface or like any modeling. So if I have to create any grading or building a plot, I could use the breaklines. So as you can see here, I have some lines, and let's see how we can convert them into breaklines and how we can use the breakline to create the surface. So I have lines, a billing pad, and I go to create feature line. First I convert them into feature line or 3D polyline. I select all and click OK and assign some level to them. Let's say 160. So I have converted now into 3D into them feature line. You can change their level anytime you want. You can see it's 160 right now. And now let's see how we convert use it in the surface. So I'm going and create new surface. I just give the random name, new surface, click OK. Now if you go to the new surface and expand this and expand this definition, here you can see the option for the break line. So click here, right click here and add. You can use these options, the weeding and supplementary factor. Weeding factor you can use where you have so many PI points. I mean so many small PI points. So if you don't want to use those small points, you can give the weeding factor. So it will, like in case you give 5 meters, so if there is a 6-7 point between the 5 meter, it will avoid it. And it will use the point of the 5 meter. So that's the use of weeding. And second is the supplementary factor. So it's the reverse of the weeding. Like you have a 5 meter 0 point and you want some point between them, so you can use the supplementary factor. So here I don't use anything. I'll just go and click OK. 1 minute, I'll just delete this and select all my breaklines instead of one. So I'll click OK and select all my breaklines and rebuild my surface. Now go to surface and select any style. So I'll go with the contour, contour and triangulation 0.1, and you can see the triangulation. And let's see in object viewer, as you can see some surface has created. So with the use of the breakline, you can create the surface. Now the next part of the beauty of the breakline, that it control your surface. So suppose if I have to change this feature line level, go to level elevation and I'll give it to 155 and 155, and you can see your surface is also asking rebuild. So your surface rebuilt, and you can see your surface has changed. Now if I go to the object viewer, and you can see that my surface has changed. Now the beauty of the breakline, it control your surface. So you can see that my surface from this breaklines haven't changed, so it stay as in. So breakline creates some wall like that. If I want to change the surface just only this point, so you can give some break lines, so the surface only change between those points, and the surface other point will remain the same. So this is also one of the use of the break line, that it control your surface where you want to change and where you don't want to change it. So, and this way you can create any building pad or any side features like this. So if I go over here and create one more break line, Instead of that, I create 3D polyline. So you can do the 3D polyline as well. So I go and create one 3D polyline. Now I click give some level to this polyline, 170 and 170. So yep, and you can add this as a break line in your surface. So you can add the break line anytime you want into your surface, and you can see it converted, so it goes to the 170. So with the use of this breakline, you can control your surface, you can create any surface for the building pad, for any side. So yep, this is the use of breakline. You can also give the labels, annotate the labels to surface. So go to the annotation, go to the add labels, here select the line and cause, select the multiple segment. Here you can have a various options. If not, you can create also and just click OK. Select your feature line, and you can see you can give them label X, Y, and Z. So this is the benefit of the breaklines. Thank you for watching our videos. I hope our videos are very informative and helping you to learn Civil 3D.